you haven't heard that things are so difficult sometimes, they complain and you wouldn't even notice. Be thankful for our fathers, the God the Father, who says, the reward of your life is not here, but a guaranteed promised land in heaven. And this is what our parents are giving us, young people. When my parents are alive, that's all they say. Go to church, go to church, go to church. Read your Bible, read your Bible. And the second advice I had on this chapter is miracle of provision. God provided provision for Joshua and the rest of them. And I gave you land whereon, and this is on verse 13, and I gave you land whereon thou hadst not labored in cities which why which you did not build in Lebanon. You ate from farms produce and olive gardens rose, which you did not plant. The moment you were born, both of us had been nourished again by our mother's milk. It's an amazing fact that without those nourishment, we would not be here. And the father would feed us with chocolate, sometimes fruit in the restaurants. And if you see a beggar on the street, you would kind of read what they are talking or thinking. You say, if only I had a father and mother like you, I would be not on the street begging for food or money. Buy something for my need. I have a payment where I have to rest my bed at night or under a bridge is my roof when it's raining and I have a temple. How I wish I had a parent like you. I have my nieces with what they call homeless kids in Kansas City. She works with them. And amazingly enough, this is three children we will see them at night. They go around like on the garbage, trying to get some food. And sometimes they will be on the restaurant window. They will look at you eating your hamburger. Like, give me some. Nobody experienced that here. As your parents provided for you. Then it comes to the miracles of protection. On verse 11, it says, you crossed the Jordan and came to Jericho and fought them. As you fight the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Girgashites, the Hittites, and the Jebusites, but I gave you victory over them. And verse 12, as you advanced them, I threw them into panic in order to drive out of two Amorite kings. Your sword and bows have nothing to do with it. Then do you know what Jesus or what God did? During the time let's say, for example, that you are in you're being attacked by the Chinese army or the Russian army. God sent Bubuyo, bees, millions of bees. And they ran away because they were beaten by each one of them. Have you ever experienced getting beaten by a bee? And it's exactly what happens. As our parents protect us from bullies and bad people by their presence alone. I remember one time when Tim and Daniel were still young. We were living in an apartment and there was a big bully riding a bike. And this big bully, even though I am there, Tina's there watching, he was kind of grabbing the bike from him. And Tina looked at me, and then when I said, I did just like that, I pick up a stick and try to run off the bully. He was only 3 years old. Because I was there. He was courageous to do that kind of stuff. This is the kind of assurance God gives to us. Whenever there's trouble, that assurance is in us. You know, you can never be a bully yourself. I was a bully by myself also. I experienced being a bully when I was 10 years old. We had an enemy so big and tall. And three of my brothers, I'm pushing in the corner. We beat him to a pulp. I mean, three of us after him could beat us. But the point is, when my father did, saw that, or heard about it, he had to lay down on the floor and each one of us got a beating that we could not see for a few days because it was so hard. I remember that. He gave us that kind of also a punishment that we remember. When you give your life to God, the Father sincerely, He will separate you from this devil's world. It means His love will separate you whatever it takes. Separation from everything else bring you to Himself. He will use everything to separate you from the rest of this ungodly world, the rejection of men, disappointments, heartbreaks, crisis, hearts and sorrows, disillusionment, unfulfillment, discontentment, troubles, abandonment, failure, whatever it takes to separate you. God is a beloved God. He doesn't want you to go astray. The world brings you all of this, but again, you are obedient to His calling. There will be a miracle of protection and guidance. Our parents are like hedges for us. You know, if you go to our house, there's hedges around our property. In Persian expression. So thick, you have to cut it. Hedges not of sticks and thorns, but it's a boundary. Hedges built of safeguard. Decisions that were tried with real godly results, guidelines, principles and standards, parameters concerning what you will, you will not allow, lines you will not allow to be crossed. Godly parents are needed to protect such children from harm. In verse 20, it says, if you reject the Lord, and serve foreign gods of this earthly life, He will turn and do you harm and consume and destroy you after He has done you good. This world, the gods, are that kind of gods. And then number four, miracle of love and forgiveness. You read to the end of the chapter of Joshua 24. God's love is unmeasurable, radical, as Belgium call it, and unchangeable. As it reads, Joshua said to the people, this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, said to you. Long ago your ancestors lived on the other side of the Euphrates River and worshiped other gods, and one of his ancestors was there of other Yamunan River. Then I took you ancestors from the land of Euphrates and led you from the whole of the kingdom and you give him provision. You know, prosperity is all over if you allow it. But there is something that we cannot understand why we are in trouble. And if we repent, that promise of love and forgiveness is over. You know, we repent. But that's another brother who lives on the United States. So many times, but we are positive. When you repent, meaning to say, you know, some people repent like this. I repent. It's not like that. I repent. It's 180 degrees. And so I guess forgiveness has its own rewards. For the people who dreams. Riches beyond the world. And unwavering protection and love and provision. In verse 38, just to send the people away, this is the blessing that they receive. Each to the land of his inheritance. And to us, as saying thank you, our parents. This is something that we have to understand. I would like to show you something that pierced my heart. I would like to show you this old man. This old man, you know, it's in the place for it. I don't know. Says here, sir, is something wrong with my phone? I don't know. Can you fix it? Can you try it? The battery is okay. So the repairman took it, look at it, check the battery. And the repairman said, sir, there's nothing wrong with your phone. The old lady was saying, how come I have not received any call from the kids for a long time? How come? And also one time, and this is for my closer. When I die, the parents are saying, don't bring me flowers on my grave. Don't come to me and tell me how much you love me and how much you miss me because of those words. I want to hear why I'm still around you. Children, wake up. No matter how old you are, we are all children. So, just a reminder, can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Let us pray. Father God, thank you for your blessings. Thank you for your love and beauty. that we are being here to be obedient to. Help us to mature in our life here on earth, to see that what we learn from our parents, we can pass on to others, to our child. Bless each one of us, that we will learn from what you taught us today. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. I would like you to play. And this is something that I saw also on the website. It's about the speech for dancing in Washington. I'm sure you might have come across it.